Every time Jon Hancock pushes on the knob of his spray can, he doesn't just release paint. He releases almost a decade of military memories.
Let's use this one.
Including when he first killed a man.
We were in Ramadi in 2004, and it, the oh shit moment was when I turned the corner and stitched a guy up from groin to neck. I turned the corner and he was there. He had an RPG, he was getting ready to sling up on his shoulder. And I had 7-8 rounds from groin right to the neck, and I just kept plugging away. And right then, that was the point where I was like, I'm in this shit. Like, I'm in it.
For 8 years, John served as a Marine, working a variety of jobs in the reconnaissance community. He eventually became an interrogator and source handler. Those 8 years with 10 deployments, including stops in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Africa, serve as inspiration for John's artwork.
I'm a huge fan of Van Gogh and The Call and a couple others, man. Like, I've always enjoyed anybody that likes to kind of go outside the box with it.
Like Van Gogh, John is plagued by his own demons, PTSD, and traumatic brain injury.
I have really vivid imaginative nightmares, and they're really crazy. Every night is a wake up in cold sweat. My sleep pattern's off. I don't sleep a lot, maybe an hour or two a day.
John joined the Marine Corps in late May 2001, but those painful memories didn't start until his second Iraq deployment.
Once you kill somebody, it just happens. If you're in the middle of a gunfight, you're not thinking about it. It almost becomes video game-ish. Afterwards, you think about it. Afterwards, you do. You think about it a lot. And whatever you did that day stays with you for the rest of your life. Because it's such a raw environment. It's so absolutely chaotic and violent. I can't explain it to you how exactly. Like, it's so bad that it just sears itself onto your memory.
Also seared into his memory, the deaths of the men he fought with, his friends, his brothers.
But I never went to most of the graves of most of the guys, and that's kind of how I dealt with it. It's sad, you know, when it happens, and you cry a lot, and, you know, why did this happen, and that comes out, and then you justify it because he was at war, and then you say he was a hero, and so all that happens. And I guess the mourning process is constant. It's an everyday thing for me.
Returning home, John began drinking heavily.
I drink to sleep, and that becomes a problem because I'm probably an alcoholic. But if I go drink, I go real hard. And there's no reason to. No reason, but I do it. One, to quell the nightmares and the memory. And two, to actually pass out and sleep for more than 2 or 3 hours.
What saved him was the artwork.
It's therapeutic. It's gotten me away from the bars a lot more. I don't really argue with where something comes from because I know it's just my head trying to get certain shit out. I just allow the art to kind of dictate for itself where it wants to go, because who am I to like question what it is that I'm trying to say when I don't even know what it is I'm trying to say.
In LANHAM, Maryland, Brandon Goldner, CNS TV.